We got scammed. Second day going around Sri Lanka. It was a really, really beautiful morning. This morning we went from our hostel, we walked and caught a bus to Negombo Center. Buses are 11 cents, it's amazing. And then we decided not to take any tuk-tuks to anywhere. It got a bit hot, but I think it's perfect right now because it's low season, so there aren't any tourists. Back everyone is looking at us because we're so different, since there aren't any others to obviously look at. Those crying eyes, it makes me wanna surrender, wrap you in my arms.
No, I try to live without regrets. So, catch. I'm always moving forward, not looking back. But I tend to leave a trail of dead while I'm moving ahead. And so I'm stepping away.
Sean, what are you doing right now?
Living my best life.
Drinking from my coconut.
Good, yo.
They're cute. They didn't steal any of my belongings. Just the bananas and watermelon, as far as we know.
Today we got scammed by a local Sri Lankan. Basically, this guy was we were trying to find the bus number 138, and he started telling us to follow him. He'll show us where. And after 2 minutes of walking, I realized that, as in, obviously no one walks more than 2 minutes just to show someone unless they're really nice. Shut the people in Sri Lanka really peep their horn. Anyway, we got scammed for 27 cents. Anyway, as I was saying, he showed us to the bus. He not offered, he demanded to take our bags and place them for us. And I'm like, no, it's okay, I can do it. And he literally started taking it off. And then basically he asked us for 300 rupees, which are 300, I think.
150.
Around 150 euro between two. So it would have been like 75 cents. But we're like, we had no idea how much the bus cost, but we already caught a few buses, so we knew straight away that, you know, it's not 300. Anyway, we kept telling him, and all of a sudden from behind him, there was a bus driver, and I see him going. And every time, obviously, the other guy turns a bit, he's like, you know, continuing his job. And there were two kids as well. They were doing the same thing to us. So I think they're either scared of him or they just don't want the hassle, but they don't want tourists to, you know, be scammed by other people. Anyway, we decided, he got us two tickets. I have no idea where he got us these two tickets from. They seemed legit, and there was written 40 rupees on them. So we figured, all right, yes, 40 rupees each is, you know, makes sense. 40 rupees is...
25, less than 25 cents.
Less than 25 cents, and we gave him 100, he didn't give us change, and we're like, you know what, just let him go. So yeah, we thought 100 rupees, which is 56 cents, 54 cents, sorry. And anyway, then the ticket guy, who was already there when the scam was happening, because he actually was there, that's why I was surprised, after a bit was like, you know, like, it's time to give you the money. So he knew about the scam. He, like, you know, it just happens. None of them said anything. And he's like, yes, but now you need to, you know, actually pay the fare, which was 14 rupees, which is 7 cents. So yeah, our bank accounts are a bit empty right now, but we survive. So we now are at a dorm in Colombo. It's like 12 beds, I think. But right now we're the only ones here. And that's why I'm vlogging. Anyway, we're in this dorm for 3 days. And there's a desk. It's my first time being in a dorm. It's Sean's. Millions and billions.
Way, yeah.
Anything I tell him I've done, he's like, that I haven't done, he's like, yeah, I've done it.
It's not my first time.
Like, for example, I was really excited we saw monkeys today. He's like, I told him that's the first time I saw monkeys in wildlife.
Yeah, I saw monkeys before.
Ha ha ha!